Hello everyone, and welcome to Sine of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and the time has come to explore the factor theorem. Now, since the factor theorem is just a very special case of the remainder theorem, I highly recommend that you brush up on the remainder theorem by checking out the video in the link above. But if you're feeling ready to go, well then let's get straight into it. Before we learn about what is stated in the factor theorem, let's first take a moment to think about what factors really are. If I asked you to list all of the factors of 6, you may say 6 and 1, or 2 and 3, since these numbers multiply together to give us 6. You may also say negative 6 and negative 1, or negative 2 and negative 3, since these numbers also multiply to give us 6. Likewise, if we are asked to factor the trinomial x squared minus 3x plus 2, we would say that the factors are x minus 1 and x minus 2, since they multiply together to give us the terms in that trinomial. Now, if we take that trinomial and we divide by the first factor of x minus 1, we notice that the remainder is 0 while the quotient is x minus 2, the second factor. And if we take that same trinomial and we divide by the second factor of x minus 2, again, we notice that the remainder is 0 while the quotient is x minus 1, the first factor. In other words, and this is really important, x minus 1 and x minus 2 are only factors because the remainder is 0. If we take the same trinomial and divide it by x minus 4, the quotient turns out to be x plus 1, while the remainder turns out to be 6. Now, we would not be able to call x minus 4 and x plus 1 factors, since the remainder is not equal to 0. And likewise, if we take that same trinomial and we divide it by x plus 1, the quotient turns out to be x minus 4, while the remainder turns out to be 6. Again, we cannot say that x minus 4 and x plus 1 are factors because the remainder is not equal to 0. This is the exact thinking behind the factor theorem, which states that x minus b is a factor of polynomial p of x if and only if p of b is equal to 0. Now, let's explore the theory to see why this is true. In a previous video, we learned that a polynomial can be written as the product of a divisor and a quotient plus a remainder. So, if a polynomial has x minus b as a factor, then by definition, the remainder has to be 0, leaving us with x minus b multiplied by the quotient. Now, if we simply substitute b in place of x, we are left with the case of b minus b multiplied by the quotient, which ultimately is just 0 multiplied by the quotient, which gives us 0. In summary, this result works both ways thanks to that if and only if statement that is used in logic. Working forwards, we can conclude that if x minus b is a factor of polynomial p of x, then p of b is equal to 0. And working backwards, we can conclude that if p of b is equal to 0, then x minus b must be a factor of that polynomial p of x. Okay, let's put the factor theorem to the test by letting p of x equal to that trinomial from earlier. If we substitute 1 in place of x, we get 0. And if we substitute 2 in place of x, we also get 0. From this, we can conclude that since p of 1 is equal to 0, x minus 1 must be a factor. And we can also conclude that since p of 2 is equal to 0, x minus 2 is also a factor, exactly what we established earlier. Now, if we try to substitute 4 in place of x, we get 6. And if we try to substitute negative 1 in place of x, we also get 6. According to the factor theorem, since p of 4 is not equal to 0, we can conclude that x minus 4 is not a factor. And since p of negative 1 is also not equal to 0, we can conclude that x plus 1 is also not a factor, exactly what we established earlier. In fact, those numbers 0 and 6 represent the remainders according to the remainder theorem. Okay, so I hope that this introduction to the factor theorem makes sense to you. And if you'd like to learn more about the factor theorem and its uses, be sure to check out the next video in this series. If you feel that you've learned something valuable from this lesson, then please let me know. And show me your skills by trying out this question and letting me know what your answer is in the comments below. If you'd like to consider the idea of supporting me and my work on Patreon, then please click on the link in the description below to learn more. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.